The poor we will always have with us, but why the hungry?
This was the driving theme that inspired a worldwide movement more than 50 years ago. The United States of America is one of the most industrialized producers of food in the entire world. Here in the U.S., we are so successful at food production that every day, nearly 40% of food produced in America will go uneaten or discarded.
But why the hungry?
Soup kitchens, shelters, and local churches have been providing free meals for over a century. But these places provide one meal at a time, and only to those who are physically able to show up. A place where a family or a shelter could get a week's worth of groceries for all of the people they feed simply did not exist. Until the 1960s, when a compassionate man named John van Hengel, along with a few other resourceful Phoenicians, came up with a simple yet groundbreaking notion. Gather food where there is an abundance and deliver it to those in need. A simple thought that no one had dreamt prior to 1967.
And St. Mary's tie-up was because St. Mary's was the ones, were the ones that gave us our impetus. They gave us our building to start with. And also they loaned me $3,000 to get this off the ground, which we paid back the first year.
So, with a $3,000 loan from his church, St. Mary's Basilica, John van Hengel secured an old abandoned bakery in South Phoenix and opened St. Mary's Food Bank, the world's first food bank. So why the name Food Bank?
The lady that we referred to that gave us the name St. Mary's Food Bank was a lady that I was called over to meet one day by one of the social service agencies, and they said, this lady has 10 children, and she's been feeding all these children out of the dumpster behind one of the local supermarkets. And of course, I was involved at that time in gathering food and storing it. We didn't have a name for our program at the time, and she took me over to the dumpster and showed me the food. And it was unbelievable what was being tossed out. About 2 days later, she came back again and she said, you see these children, they're all healthy. And I said, my gosh, they're a real healthy looking bunch. And she said, there should be some kind of a place where people could put in food for those of us in need and then we could take it out. And she said, kind of a bank like. And she said, a bank of food. And I said, that's it, food bank. And so that's where the name came from.
While St. Mary's Food Bank may have invented the first food bank, they're certainly not the only one today. After the first food bank launched in Phoenix, the word quickly spread and other states began to follow John's lead. By 1977, there were food banks in 18 cities across the country. As the number of food banks began to increase, John created a national organization for food banks, and in 1979, he established Second Harvest, later called America's Second Harvest, the nation's food bank network. In 2008, the network changed its name to Feeding America to better reflect the mission of the organization. In 1984, food banking had reached Europe with the establishment of the first food bank in France. By 1999, there were more than 50,000 food pantries established across the U.S., many of which being supplied with food from area food banks. With so many new food banks operating across the world, the Global Food Banking Network was established in 2006. Currently, there are more than 200 food banks across the United States and Puerto Rico. Globally, there are hundreds of food banks across 25 countries. The food bank is essentially a food storage and distribution center, a clearinghouse where individuals and businesses donate or deposit excess food or money into the bank. Those in need can then withdraw or pick up large quantities of food for their agency or bring home to their family. Today, food banks have taken the clearinghouse storage concept to remarkable levels. Established food banks like St. Mary's utilize technology, logistics, and thousands of dedicated volunteers in order to provide more than 250,000 pounds of food every day.
St. Mary's Food Bank is a member of Feeding America, and not only the first food bank, but one of the largest in the country. It means that we have the resources and the tools available to meet whatever need may come our way. We can deal with increases because we have capacity. We can be there in remote areas because we have enough trucks. We can be there to help out and send food because we have enough inventory. It's the dedication of our people, the dedication of our donors and our board of directors that provide us these tools so that we can be there wherever the need may be.
One of the first things that happened to us here at St. Mary's Food Bank when we got the news that coronavirus was happening and companies were being sent home to work from home is that our volunteer shifts went down basically to nothing. We went from having about 120 volunteers a day to fewer than 20, and that posed a really big challenge for us. When our volunteers dipped, we realized that we actually had to call in the National Guard to help us. And they helped us pack boxes, and they just immediately went to work. Some of them knew how to drive trucks, some of them knew how to use forklifts, and they were our volunteer support. And they actually came and helped us for months to come.
I volunteer here because it gives me great joy, knowing that I'm making a difference out there for the people that are in need of food to put on their tables, and sometimes there are people that are having a rough time due to this pandemic.
You could see it in their faces. Not only do they not have enough food, but they're worried about their job. They're worried about their children. Their kids aren't going to school anymore. The meals that the children got in schools are no longer there. Even we had fear of the pandemic for our own personal safety. Yet every employee here at St. Mary's was dedicated and came to work every day because they knew that what they did was important and was critical to the whole community. And they were not going to let the people in our community who are in need, they were not going to let them down.
So here is a time when people are working from home or when people are out of work and not working at all. That was not the situation for us at St. Mary's Food Bank. That was our time. Every one of our employees was still coming into work, doing everything that we could to make sure that we had enough food here so that we could meet this need that we'd never seen before. We gave out more food in 1 month than we had in any other month in our 53-year history.
So as the COVID pandemic hit, it really impacted the economy and also our sources of food. We got a lot of food from the retail grocery stores. Well, because the grocery stores were hit hard, there wasn't a lot of food left over that we could take and redistribute. But on the other side, the food service distributors had excess food and were able to take that excess food and funnel that to the people in our community who were in need.
With the support of key private sector relationships, what was once considered the home of dented canned food is now home to fresh produce, dairy, eggs, meat, starches, bottled water, and more. More than 40% of all the food distributed by St. Mary's Food Bank is fresh Arizona-grown produce.
Providing food to the people in our community is not just enough. We need to provide nutritious food. And so as an organization, over the years we've invested to ensure that we have state-of-the-art refrigeration so we can handle and deliver more fresh produce and more nutritious foods to the people in our community.
Because of these efficiencies, St. Mary's Food Bank is able to provide food assistance to over two-thirds of Arizona, from Phoenix to the northern border and everywhere in between. It was once thought that people receiving assistance at food banks are primarily comprised of the homeless looking for a handout. Actually, they often have jobs, families, or they may have even served our country. You may not recognize them because they're just like the rest of us, only perhaps in the midst of hard times, a health issue, underemployment, between jobs or education. They're making difficult decisions every day, like paying the power bill or putting food on the table. Should they put gas in the car that gets them to work or feed their children for the week? This is where St. Mary's Food Bank provides the biggest impact.
The people that came to us during the pandemic were people who a month earlier were donors. See a brand new car come through. Say, oh, do they need help? Well, a month earlier, they had a good paying job that they thought would never end, and they went out and bought a new car. Now they've got a car payment and no job and no money to put food on the table. They didn't know where to go. They didn't know what to do, but they knew one thing: they could come to St. Mary's. They'd be welcomed and they'd be given what they need to help put food on their table.
He's an Army vet, and I'm proud of him.
I get a lot of people as I go up down the street say thank you for serving the country. You'd be surprised. A lot of people.
Without St. Mary's, we would literally have starved without the needs that we are supplied by St. Mary's. So yes, Yes, we have money, but not enough to cover all of our needs. Choices like who eats, the dogs, the cats, or us? Do we let go a bill so we can eat this month? That sort of thing goes through our minds every month. Knowing that it's there and that we have access means one less worry about where our money goes. We know that it's there for us if we need it, and all we have to do is explore the avenues that help that. And if I could donate, I'd donate to St. Mary's.
Thanks to St. Mary's Food Bank and my cooking, my bride is going to eat well tonight.
No, seriously. To the donors, you're doing an inestimable service for people who can't get where they need to go to get what they need. You see us in our circumstances, so here's where it goes.
I worked in the hotel industry pre-COVID. We were very busy, worked all the time. So then when COVID hit, changed everything dramatically for us. Myself and over 200 of my colleagues were all furloughed, effective immediately. Everyone was suddenly and unexpectedly left with no work, no clue how long this was going to last, no clue what we were going to do. Paychecks stopped immediately. There was a lot of panic, a lot of fear, a lot of confusion. Being able to be on the recipient end as the weeks went by and the weeks went by and we weren't going back to work and other things weren't kicking in yet, we were able to utilize this assistance to help put food on the table when we weren't sure how else we would be able to. Because of St. Mary's Food Bank, I didn't have to make difficult decisions on which bills to pay.
Pre-COVID, I was working full-time, had a great job that I loved, and then when COVID hit, literally probably 95% of our associates were furloughed, myself included. You have limited income coming in now, where I used to have a full paycheck, and now I'm deciding what bills will be paid this month versus next month, what expenses can I cut out, and it's tough. I've been coming to St. Mary's as a volunteer for years. When COVID hit, it directly impacted myself because I was furloughed. It's very difficult even being brought back to work. Now we're at a substantial pay cut, so we come to St. Mary's to help offset our grocery bills. So that's been a huge help to us. And then again, just even volunteering when we can, because we love being here actually. St. Mary's has been incredible and it helps so many people. I'm here as a volunteer and I see all the cars that are lined up waiting to come through. I've been in the receiving end as well in my car, and literally it's just for hours, just vehicle after vehicle after vehicle of all these families coming for food. So it's wonderful, wonderful organization.
A lot of people gotta make sacrifices, including myself. And there are some bills that can wait just a little bit, not too long, you know. But if you need the food, you need the food.
There's no shame in asking for food assistance. There's only respect and compassion for better days ahead. At the Knight Center in Phoenix and Surprise, Arizona, thousands of food assistance boxes are distributed to families each day. The process is less intimidating than most people think. Caring professionals and volunteers guide people through every step, assuring they receive the support and services they need.
Pre-COVID, never. I never thought I would be on the receiving end. But it really has been a huge help. For myself, my situation, being furloughed, St. Mary's was there for me. It was a blessing, and again, one that I've been here as a volunteer for years and years and years. Never thought I would need to come here for my groceries, but I know St. Mary's will be here 100% anytime I need to come.
I have actually explained to so many people that I work with and family of mine that it is such an amazing experience, and that I also had no idea what to expect from a food bank or anything, but that it was everyone is welcome and that all kinds of people come and take advantage of the assistance that it's provided here, and that there is no shame in asking for help. That is what St. Mary's is here for, is to help you when you need it. And right now, a lot of people need it.
There were some people that actually made donations to us in December that gave us a call in the beginning of April and said, I need to go ahead and stop my monthly contribution because I've been laid off. And then through the course of the conversation, we actually shared with them, you know, if you need help, that's what we are here for. That's what you've been supporting. And there were a lot of people that were donors that actually became clients of St. Mary's Food Bank. You know, it's really hard to ask for help when you need it and when you haven't needed that help before. But this being such a different circumstance for people, they're really happy that St. Mary's Food Bank was here to help them.
It makes me feel amazing to have discovered St. Mary's Food Bank, because not only does it give me a sense of purpose and that I can help a little bit, even in this time of need for so many, but it also gives me a sense of security. I will not go hungry. I will not worry about where I'm going to get my next meal, because I know that St. Mary's is here for me and everyone else like me out there.
People who can't make it to the food bank are still eligible to receive assistance. St. Mary's delivers food to more than 40 rural and urban locations throughout central and northern Arizona with its mobile pantry program. A St. Mary's food bank truck brings perishable food directly to neighborhoods in the greatest need. Pallets of fruit, vegetables, and bread are available for dozens of families needing the nutritious food. This massive endeavor is accomplished through a fleet of over 50 vehicles that travel annually over 1.4 million miles to distribute, rescue food, meet with partner agencies, and mobile pantry sites. That's as many miles as traveling around the world over 56 times.
So about 2 years ago, our board of directors challenged the leadership of St. Mary's Food Bank to come up with innovative ideas to expand our reach. We had used some geospatial software, ArcGIS, to map out our state and figure out where what we call hotspots are. Where, in other words, where there's underserved communities. We landed on what we call mobile distributions. Mobile distributions is trucks and trailers like the one sitting behind us that allow us to take a mobile pantry or a mobile market into a community and do a pop-up distribution. Now that COVID has come around and affected so many communities, we're able to go in and just pop in for one day. Again, this gives us the ability to go all over the state. So we've done them as far north as Tuba City, as far east as Window Rock. We've gone to Lake Havasu, Bullhead City. You know, we've gone all over the state with these mobile trucks.
In addition to directly supporting people and families within the community, St. Mary's Food Bank provides the bulk of its food donations to other nonprofits throughout Arizona.
As the pandemic unfolded, we saw a lot of things change. 75% of our food that we distribute through other agencies who give the food to the people in need. We saw many of them close. We had to step in with mobile distribution and fill those voids. And the 25% that we distribute directly ourselves, now we had a dilemma. In the old world, pre-pandemic, people would come into our building, would sit down with an intake person, provide their information, and then walk out with a shopping cart of food that a volunteer took out and helped load in their car. With social distancing, that could never happen. So we had to change our entire paradigm of how we did it. And so we went to a complete 100% drive-through model, where today people drive up, they hold their ID up to the window of their car without rolling their window down, we key in their information, they pop their trunk, we load their trunk, no contact. Safe for our clients, safe for our volunteers, safe for our team.
Here at the food bank, I enter clients' information into the system, and I give them boxes of food, the emergency food box and also the senior food box as well.
The bulk of the 250,000 pounds of food distributed every day are comprised of donations for hundreds of partner nonprofits throughout central and northern Arizona.
One of the most critical areas of need here in Arizona is on tribal lands, and in particular in Navajo Nation, which is in the northeast part of our state. And historically, there's been plenty of challenges in order to try to get food up there, just because there's just not a lot of infrastructure in order to help us distribute food in that geographic area.
Pre-COVID, we were working with about 15 chapter houses. The chapter house is a local government on tribal lands. And because of COVID, we were able to reach out to all 57 chapter houses in Arizona, and we're now working with over 50 of them. There are a lot of communities, there are extremely rural locations, very remote, and in those cases, we're able to take these mobile market trucks into that area. So where there's still gaps, where there's no chapter house, we're able to take these mobile markets in. We've been able to expand our reach throughout tribal lands.
Innovation and efficiency has been a staple theme at St. Mary's Food Bank since inception, and that innovation innovation has led to additional programs that have spawned the same overwhelming spirit of giving. After all, the St. Mary's Food Bank mission statement is to alleviate hunger through the gathering and distribution of food while encouraging self-sufficiency, collaboration, advocacy, and education. Following the notion, teach a man to fish and he could feed his family for life, St. Mary's Food Bank created a program called Community Kitchen in 2000.
We are a program that helps individuals who are looking to make a change in their life provide for themselves. The mission is to help disadvantaged adults achieve self-sufficiency through training and job placement, but I look at it as a little bigger than that. I want to see people be successful. The main criteria to become a student, you're going to be facing some sort of barrier to employment. Whether that was an incarceration, whether that was you're a victim of domestic violence, substance abuse and recovery. I have some individuals who are 18 years old and have no hireable skills yet, have never really worked, but are now in a position where they need to provide for themselves. So we're able to kind of give them that springboard into a career.
I was in federal prison. I got into my addiction, took over my life, and so I did some time, and when I got out, and it was just really difficult for me to get into the employment field, so I decided to go to Community Kitchen.
So we are a 12-week program. You are here Monday through Friday from 7 to 3. So 40 hours a week for 12 weeks is a huge commitment, but it is an investment in oneself.
I was at the Community Kitchen working and then came to the food bank.
The knife skills aside and the kitchen skills aside, it's the life skills portion. It's the birth or rebirth of self-confidence you see a lot in the students. The ability to know that they have a skill they can take out into the world and provide for themselves when they've never been given that opportunity up until this point, I think is the most powerful piece.
I feel like I'm giving back to the community because I was given this opportunity through St. Mary's to be here and be an employee here, and I'm just giving back to them now.
Teach a man to fish, right? And he never goes hungry, so we really sort of provide that piece.
More than just helping those in need, we want to help those so they can help themselves. Our Community Kitchen program, which is our culinary training program for people with barriers to employment. But now we're adding an additional opportunity of training, and that is warehouse training. So we'll train people to operate forklifts, pallet jacks, so they can go get a job in a warehouse, which there's plenty of those opportunities here in Arizona, and take care of their families.
Yeah, I was basically homeless, and then I heard about the Community Kitchen program at St. Mary's. And so I decided to give them a call, and after the Community Kitchen program, they got me a job working in the industry at a restaurant. And I worked there until the COVID-19 hit, and I was laid off, unfortunately, because they closed all the restaurants down. Well, basically what I was thinking was like, oh, what am I going to do now? I know a lot of families and individuals that's, you know, got laid off on their jobs and stuff, and they became homeless. Then I got a call the next day asking me if I was interested in working for St. Mary's. Here at St. Mary's Food Bank, I work in the warehouse, and my basic duties are to keep the warehouse clean, because it's very important, because we handle food and we distribute food to keep the warehouse very clean. And I take pride in my job, and I keep the warehouse spotless. And that makes me feel good that I know I have received numbers of compliments from the company and individuals that come on tours that say how spotless my warehouse looks.
So when someone comes to us who has a barrier to employment, we now have two choices: culinary training, warehouse training. Either way, it helps people get back on their own two feet, not have to rely on a food bank, but be able to rely upon themselves.
The compassion for helping those in need is especially great when addressing child hunger. 1 in 4 children in Arizona live in poverty, one of the highest rates in the nation. While they may have breakfast and lunch at school, they might not get enough food at night and on the weekends. Hence, Kids Cafe, a St. Mary's Food Bank program that ensures children get one more healthy meal before they leave school at the end of the day. More than 1 million healthy meals are delivered annually to students in after-school and summer programs. What's more, the Backpack program sends approximately 700 chronically hungry children home with food on Fridays to ensure they have something to eat over the weekend.
St. Mary's Food Bank has played a very important role in our school. with the students.
I eat breakfast because it helps me learn in class. I like apples, grapes, carrots, and lettuce.
We have over 90% of students having food assistance here, free and reduced meals that we serve to them.
If I didn't have breakfast, I think I would get a lower grade, like a D.
When you have a kid who hasn't had any breakfast at all, you're sure that that kid won't be able to digest whatever the teacher is saying. So that is the most important meal that we serve to the kids.
If I missed a meal, I wouldn't be able to concentrate.
It's hard to concentrate when you're hungry.
There was a time that kids would come just late from wherever they're coming. They come in and they're like, I'm hungry, I didn't have breakfast.
If they don't have dinner at home, it's either they just save, like they eat part of the kids' cafe meal and save it until they get hungry again.
And they're very grateful for the St. Mary's Food Bank.
Well, the Arizona Charitable Tax Credit is a wonderful way for people to support St. Mary's Food Bank. You're already paying state taxes, so why not take that money and redirect it to St. Mary's Food Bank? That money then can go to feed people right here in our community that are in need, many of them for the first time.
Like, I don't have everything in the world. I have me, I'm alive. I may not be able to walk on my own 2 feet, you know, all myself. It's just me in my wheelchair. And yes, I do donate. I do donate a few dollars here and there, you know, and it's also to show the people out there that there are a lot of nice people like myself out there, you know, able to help. And I do really very much thank St. Mary's Food Bank for helping me and the other people that really in dire need of food.
And if I could donate, I'd donate to St. Mary's.
What started out as an innovative idea to help feed the hungry has blossomed into a worldwide movement. Currently, there are over 200 food banks in the United States and hundreds more around the world, helping tens of millions of people every day find their next meal and transition into self-sustainability. All thanks to a man and his desire to help those in need.
We don't know what the future is going to bring, but we know with the support from the community, we can handle whatever comes our way.
Poor we will always have with us, but why the hungry?
Since 1967, St. Mary's Food Bank remains a team of extraordinarily compassionate and innovative people who just happen to be operating the world's first food bank. Their number one goal remains to work themselves out of business when going out of business means ending hunger. And for that, tens of millions of people around the world are grateful.
This has been an unprecedented year at St. Mary's Food Bank.
He's an Army vet, and I'm proud of him.
I get a lot of people as I go up down the street to say thank you for serving the country.
Without St. Mary's, we would literally have starved. Do we let go a bill so we can eat this month? That sort of thing goes through our minds every month.
If you need help or if you can help, go to stmarysfoodbank.org.
That's stmarysfoodbank.org.